What's up, Knights? Welcome back to the studio.
In this week's episode, we'll learn more about a teacher's recent life-threatening surgery, an upperclassman tradition that keeps you on your toes, and a historic local restaurant dating back to 1966.
Stay tuned, and on the episode of your favorite student newscast starts right now. Welcome back, Knights. We have a great show planned for you today.
On today's show, we'll be...
Whoa, what's going on with the teleprompter?
Use your word!
What's going on?
What are you saying?
I can't hear you.
Guys, I'm here.
You're late!
You're watching The Studio.
Wow, that was a mess. I'm surprised we were able to pull off the show. I hope The Legend of Friday the 13th doesn't ruin the fact that it's finally Friday.
Hey Knights, I'm Zoe White.
And I'm Maya Mudry.
My last Friday was crazy. I think one of the craziest moments is when Mr. Dilly won the tug of war against Coach Baker.
I know, it was insane. Here are a few shots from the assembly, just in case you missed it.
Knights, I know we can all agree that I Want It That Way by Backstreet Boys is one of the best jams to sing in the car. Lulu recently caught up with a few teachers to hear their favorite jams in our latest edition of Golf Cart Karaoke.
What's up, Knights? Today I had the honor of riding around with some of Higley's teachers to get to know them a little bit better. Hope you enjoy it.
Hello, I'm Mr. Batsios. I teach 12th grade government.
My name is Alana Charnowski. I teach 11th.
What was the worst thing you've ever done as a kid?
How about, what was one of the times that I didn't do something bad as a kid?
Touching me, touching you.
What else makes me cringe? Any song by Creed. Can you take me higher? Nope, can't do it.
Oh, that's my mom.
You'd rather the aliens that make it first contact be organic or robotic?
Andaba haciendo algo para un proyecto.
Truman, Doris Day, Red China, Johnny Ray, South Pacific, Walter Mitchell, Joe DiMaggio.
What's the most memorable moment that's happened in one of your classrooms?
The beloved Danny Kittner choking on beef jerky.
Giving him almost the Heimlich and then him throwing up on me.
I don't remember the words, but I like the song.
A close second was making aluminum foil hats in my first period last year.
What would be on the gag reel of your life?
Me as a teacher.
Broke it.
It's me slipping on a banana like 2 years ago when I pretended to not slip on a banana and I really slipped on a banana and I really hurt my wrist.
What's your spear down?
Probably a dog because I feel like I act like a dog.
Honey badger. Oh, yeah, okay. So there you go. I'm small, but I can rip your head off. It's either that or Ethan Kennerly. I like how you're like, oops, look on my phone, there's Backstreet Boys.
When I say I want it that way, tell me why it ain't nothing but...
Come to the HCPA next Wednesday night for the Higley Choir Program's first concert of the year. The theme, In Remembrance, celebrates the lives of loved ones lost and the fond memories we've shared with them. Tickets are available at the door. $5 for adults, $3 for students, and HUSD staff members are free. The concert begins at 7 p.m. Please consider coming out to support the choir program and all the hard work they put into preparing the music for you.
The Higley volleyball team is back in full swing, or should I say, set. On Tuesday, they took on Notre Dame Prep. Freshmen and JV won their games. Good job, girls. Their next game is on Tuesday at home against Mountain View with JV starting at 4. Come out and support our Lady Knights.
Zoe, homecoming week was insane. I'm so impressed by the student section at the football game.
I know, right? The game was amazing. Everyone was so excited to see the football team get their first of many wins this season.
Here are a few highlights from Friday Night Lights. Higley's varsity football and spirit line teams are in Seattle right now. They're taking on Rainier Beach High School. Make sure you wish them good luck this weekend.
One of our Spanish teachers here at Higley, Mr. Taylor, spent most of last year recovering from major heart surgery. Michaela and Chase have the story.
Spanish teacher Mr. Taylor has been teaching here at Higley for over 10 years. Last year, he underwent a life-threatening surgery that almost took his life, so we decided to catch up with him and find out why he returned to Higley.
Well, I was in the hospital to get an angiogram, which was supposed to detect what was going on inside my heart. And then they told us after the procedure was done, a few hours later, that there was blockage. And we found out later that day that I'd have to do open heart surgery.
The surgery may have gone smoothly, but the recovery process was definitely rocky.
The very scary part was the next day, and when they tried to get him up and all of his organs started shutting down, and trying to understand it, what that meant. And we really didn't know what it meant.
We knew it was going to be hard. I never really thought once after the surgery was all done that he would die or we'd lose him. I was more worried about his quality of life because I knew he loved to teach. He loved to come to all of our games and stuff. I was thinking if he's on a walker or something, that's going to like just kill him.
The other thing that motivated me to get better was to return to my jobs, and I was really excited more than ever to get back.
It was really hard to see your dad, and it was hard to see him just completely sedated in a hospital bed. There were so many complications, anywhere from pulmonary embolism, he got MRSA in his lungs, and they kept him sedated, and he was in the hospital for 3 weeks.
We didn't know if we were going to come out of it. So, but I wanted to be positive and I wanted to be as, you know, upbeat as possible.
I've found some of the nurses that took care of me and thanked them and had a little moment there with them for what they did. They took care of every need I had.
We are glad Mr. Taylor's surgery was successful and he is thriving teaching here back at Higley. Reporting for the studio, this is Chase and Michaela.
Marching Band has a competition coming up September 21st at Castile. Talk to a band member for additional details. They would love to see you there.
Gotcha!
What was that for?
You're out, and assassins.
What do you mean?
Like, you're out? Never mind. Lacey and I will tell you all about it in this next story.
Assassins is a well-known tradition here at Higley. We asked some Higley Knights to tell us all about the game.
So basically, Assassins, there's gonna be 70 teams, each the group of four. And so basically the concept of the game is you're assigned to another team. You have to go over when they're not in a safe zone, which includes school, work, your house, church, and go and get like a container full of water and then pour it on them somehow.
Zoe and I met up with some upperclassmen to see how they think the 2019 game is going to go.
How this year's gonna go? For my team? Oh, we're winning. We're beating everybody.
I think this year is gonna go good. Last year was kind of a bust, but I'm prepared more this year, I think.
Honestly, I don't really know what to expect, but like, I'm actually gonna like try my hardest because like, I'm trying to get that pot and that bread.
I think that this year is gonna go great. My team, amazing. I'm really hoping that we win this year, but I mean, I don't know. I mean, it's only my junior year.
But how good could this year go without a strategy? We talked to some students to see their plans on how to stay in.
My strategy to stay in is to not tell anyone what I'm doing or where I'm going and to stay home and low key.
Our main goal is to get Anthony out first. even though we don't have them, but they just want to get them out. We're going to be the best team.
I don't want to reveal my strategy, of course. But like my strategy, you know, I want to hang out with my group for assassins. Like we could stay away from like other people who we don't want us getting out. So yeah.
With these strategies in mind, two seniors have some things to say to anyone still left in the game.
What I have to say is trust no one, because there's been a bunch of people that have been assigned to their friends.
You guys are not good. You're not going to get me out. You don't know where I live. I'm European, so I won't let you get anywhere near my house. I'll have my mom take care of it. It's easy. Nobody's going to get me. Nobody will.
This is Lacey.
And this is Zoe,
reporting for The Studio.
If you could choose any time period to live in, what would it be?
I would definitely choose the 80s. The colors are so fun.
Lucky for us, the Higley Theater Company is putting on a production of William Shakespeare's A Midsummer Night's Dream with an 80s twist.
The following video was produced, shot, and edited by members from our drama group, the Nightlight Company. Check it out.
Nice job, drama students. Really love the video you made. Performances for A Midsummer Night's Dream will run September 24th through the 26th in the HCPA. Shows start at 7 p.m. and you can purchase your tickets for only $5. Be sure to come out and support your Higley Thespians.
The next time you and your friends are sitting around at home, bored out of your minds without any idea of what to do, consider heading down to the Scottsdale Museum of Contemporary Arts.
Jacob and Jack recently headed to Scottsdale to check out the exhibits.
Not sure what to do this weekend?
Then the Scottsdale Museum of Contemporary Arts is the spot for you. Jack and I spoke with some employees on their thoughts of the museum's artwork.
Other art museums may be a little bit larger and a little bit more intimidating. You kind of walk in, you don't know where to start. So we're a smaller museum, and we try to cater to the community and bring artists and artworks to the community.
We're completely dedicated to contemporary art, and we're the largest contemporary art museum in the Southwest. And one thing that's just wonderful about us is that we essentially empty and then fill up again this entire building three times a year. So think of it that way. Everything that's in here now will be out of here in a few months with brand new work in its place. And you just can't get more current than that. My favorite art that's here right now is called Cracked Mud by the artist Daniel Rosen. And it's the most beautifully engineered piece. It's really complicated. It has a motion sensor and it sets off ripples in this dried cracked earth as you walk around it. And I really love the artist because I got to work with him and he was a wonderful guy to work with.
One of my favorites is the interactive projection in one of the galleries by an artist named Marpy. It's video and it's animation. They're also using AI and he created his own app for it. So I love what he's doing with that artwork because he's finding new ways to engage.
The majority of work that we show here has been made brand new on these walls with the artists by their hand. So we'll often commission work and they will be here making it. So you can't really beat that vibrant dynamic that you get from having someone make their work here in the space.
If you want to see these amazing works of art, check out their website at smoca.org. This is Jacob and Jack reporting for the studio.
Come out and support our unified football team as they take on the Hamilton Huskies next Tuesday at 6 p.m. on our home field. These athletes have been working hard to achieve the goal of an undefeated season.
Starting Monday, the Armory will have a new $4 deal called the Midnight Snack Pack, where you can get any drink, any chip, and an Uncrustable for $4. Red Bulls are also included in this offer. Go check out the Armory and purchase your Midnight Snack Pack.
Matt, did you go to the homecoming dance last weekend?
Of course I did. It was a great start to the school year.
Check out the highlights. A lot has changed this year with our Higley High staff. Maddie and Ashley caught up with one of our new assistant principals, Mrs. Johnson.
Mrs. Johnson is one of the vice principals here at Higley High School. Her career in the Higley Unified School District started off as a teacher 9 years ago.
My journey with the Higley District started in 2013 when I interviewed with Dr. Thomason for a position. Here at Higley High School, he was the interim principal, and it would be teaching here at Higley and opening up a brand new middle school. So I've enjoyed building a new school with a lot of the teachers that are here at Higley now and just getting to know the people in the district that support all of our students and programs. What made me want to start teaching was just the experiences that I had in high school and in college and being able to kind of provide those opportunities for other students.
I'm excited to see what Ms. Johnson has to bring to the school and the positive improvements she's going to make. I've seen her a lot around campus, between classes, and at lunch.
The Higley School District stood out compared to others to Mrs. Johnson.
The activities that we have planned here are some of my favorite, so it's nice to be able to continue to work in the school where you know the traditions and you know the family so well. The reason I wanted to work at Higley is because it's very similar to the community that I grew up in. I like working in Higley because I connect pretty well with the families and the students, and I enjoy working with all the teachers here at Higley. My favorite part about this job is that I still get to work with students and work on student opportunities like field trips and club activities. So that's something that I really enjoyed doing as a student and doing with my students as a teacher. So now I get to help make those opportunities happen.
Three words to describe Mrs. Johnson. Well, she's really outgoing, she's really friendly, and she's probably one of my favorite people here at Higley.
We look forward to seeing the positive improvements Mrs. Johnson will make to Higley. Reporting for the studio, I'm Maddie Farrell.
And Ashley L.
Man, I'm hungry.
Yeah, me too. Want to go grab something after school?
What were you thinking?
How about Joe's Farm Grill?
I love that place.
Yeah, they have tons of options, from burgers and fries to milkshakes and cheesecake, not to mention the history behind the restaurant itself. Ellie and I went to check it out.
Joe's Farm Grill, located on Higley and Ray, is not only nutritious and delicious, they also serve up character and a hardworking team.
My name is Bill Eaton, and I'm the general manager here at Joe's Farm Grill. The atmosphere and energy here at the restaurant is quite lively. Usually on a Friday night, we'll serve anywhere from 600 to 800 people. It's a festive environment, even waiting in line, because we now have this open kitchen, which allows the guests to see in and actually see their food being made.
We're different from other restaurants because we have a farm-to-table type of restaurant, and so everything comes from locally grown farms.
So everything we do in the kitchen is made from scratch. Our burger meat, hamburgers, patties are locally grown here. The cows are actually down in Pinal County, and they go over to Tullison, and then they actually end up over here at Joe's Farm Grill. So quite a different thing. So you're not going to get that at many restaurants here in the Valley.
Joe's Farm Grill is known for its satisfying food, but many might not know about its history.
Joe's Farm Grill was founded in October of 2006. This was actually the home that Joe grew up in. This was a house they converted into a restaurant, believe it or not. Joe's Farm Grill is mid-century modern. And so if you were to go in our bathrooms, and some people find it interesting, some people get freaked out. They're like, what's with the dolls? Well, if you look at them closely, they're Barbie dolls, right? And some G.I. Joe dolls. Those were quite popular in the 50s and 60s. And then we have movies playing in the bathrooms as well. There's a Jetsons, a Johnny Quest, Thunderbirds, and Stingray. and all those were quite popular TV shows in the 50s and 60s. I think you should come eat at Joe's Farm Grill because we offer some delicious food in a clean environment with friendly people. So I'd say, why would you not come to eat at Joe's Farm Grill?
Remember to stop by Joe's Farm Grill when you want a quick bite. Reporting for the studio, Ellie and Maya.
That's it for this week. Thanks for watching, Knights.
Be sure to follow us on Twitter and Instagram at TheStudioHHS.
We'll be back next Friday with all your campus news and more. Have a great weekend, Knights.